once upon a time, in a wild, wild world, there were two wolf brothers living in their home lair with their papa wolf. They all lived happily together, but one day, the hunters took their dad away. Forever. So now the brothers were alone, and they had to find a new home. They started a journey through the great big forest. The wolf brothers wandered for days and nights, learning how to live on their own for the first time. They slept in the backwoods among creepy creatures and barely ate anything. They eventually found a peaceful orchard and were able to eat in peace. But they didn't know. Hunters tried to tie them up, but the wolf brothers managed to escape with the help of a friendly bear. He showed them how to survive and helped them find a warm camp for the night. That's when the big brother discovered that the little one was not an ordinary wolf, but a super wolf. That's how they found themselves even further, headed to the faraway land of their pop, where they hope to find peace.
Try with this one.
That one's too easy. Look.
Don't brag. It was too heavy for you a few days ago.
Let's try to lift something else. Not too heavy, though. I'm a little tired.
I'm so glad Daniel took this little girl with us.
How about that one?
I can do it with the small rocks, but not the big ones.
You can do this. Trust me. Just relax. Focus.
I'll try.
Holy shit!
I did it!
Like a boss. You're getting good at
this. You see that mushroom? That was the biggest rock ever.
Yeah.
Dude, it's getting late and cold. Let's get done with this practice session. Welcome to Telekinesis 101. Please don't kill your teacher. How about trying out that rock over there? Just one more time.
Come on! No, it's too far. Stop trying to make fun of me.
Just one more time.
Oh, I'm so close. I can feel it.
You could try and lift Mushroom.
What? Are you stupid? You want to hurt her.
Yeah, you're probably right. Let's leave the puppy out of this. Dude, it's getting late and cold. Let's get done with this practice session. Is this one too big?
Yeah, it's just way too massive.
How about those cans? Can you fly them all together without dropping any?
Sure, look.
That's awesome, dude. You're getting way better at this. Come on, dude. That's just the start. Let's try something else.
Cool. You're like Coach Aaron. You're my power coach. A snowball fight?
Not yet. This is a new exercise, young apprentice. See if you can stop this in the air. Cool?
Okay, but you better not hit me. Like that time you gave me a bruise? Serious.
You won't let me, right?
Try it. One more.
Ready?
Yes! Look! Look what I can do, Sean.
I knew that you could. I've taught you well. But you, you're a master student. Hey. That still sounds nasty. You're not getting better.
I told you. I'm fine. Just a little beat.
Well, you need to rest now. Superhero.
Can we go back now?
Yeah. Let's just fill up the canteens before we head back. That cough has been going on for days, Daniel. I really don't like that.
I told you. I'm fine. We've just been outside for a while.
We should fill these up now. Don't want to go out during the night. Here we go.
The helitanker is over the wildfire zone. Get ready for water extraction. Ranger Diaz.
Nice work, Daniel. Glad to see our training sessions are paying off.
Thanks to you. So glad I don't have to touch that water. It's too fucking cold. Oops. Sorry. I said fucking.
It's fine out here. There's no one to hear you curse. Say whatever the fuck you want.
Cool. What What did you find, Shroom?
Finding that house was... Hey, it's been a while since we last saw that rabbit who lives in there.
Yeah. I hope it wasn't eaten by a bear, or... worse.
What's worse than... A family of rabbits lives out here. Just like us. What's worse than a bear, Inanno?
I don't know. Wolves?
Don't worry. We're the only wolves around.
Sean? The family that lived here, what do you think happened to them?
They must have moved out. Maybe to another state.
But they left all their stuff behind?
I don't know, man. Maybe they live in Florida and only come here every 10 years. Maybe they got tired of these woods.
Well, I'm glad they left. This is our lair now. I miss my friends and my room. Sometimes.
Yeah. Me too.
Cold.
Don't worry. We'll make a fire. We're pros now. Dude, that cough doesn't sound too good.
Nah, I'm okay. Just cold.
You kicked ass today. Level up.
I did. That was so cool. It's getting easier every day. Oh no, Sean. This is a haunted house.
More like, uh-oh. It's time to go over the rules. I told you about showing off.
I was just... Whatever. Dude, I know the rules.
Let's find out. What's the first one? Hide your power. If you spin one plate in a diner, what happens?
People will freak out.
And when people freak, what do?
They call the cops.
Exactly. The second rule is...
Never talk about it.
Wow. Nice, Daniel. Because that's usually the hardest rule for you.
Shut up.
And the final rule?
I know.
Come on. You can do it.
Okay. Avoid danger?
Run from danger. This is the most important one. You know why?
I don't know. I mean, with my power, I can help us.
Only as a total last resort.
How will I know that?
If there's any other way of helping, do that first.
Maybe if I had used it before, Dad might still be here.
Daniel, it's my fault. I shouldn't have let you alone outside.
But I didn't help. I didn't do anything.
Because you couldn't.
Don't worry, Mushroom. I'm okay. Good puppy.
She must be hungry. What about you?
I'm always hungry.
Then let's grub out. I'll make us some dinner.
Yeah. Before she eats us.
for takeoff.
Shit. Where did I put my lighter?
Thank you.
kind of weird to use stranger stuff every day, but not like we have a choice. I hate it when I hear Daniel crying at night. I can't do shit.
What sadistic theme do you have in mind today?
Hey, Shroom. You thirsty? Good girl.
HQ, I'm flying over the city.
Daniel must have been pissed that day. Don't blame him. Poor guy. I guess kids have to grow up anyway, right? Yep. No more indoor training sessions.
Taking pictures of aliens?
We never found the key to this door.
Then report to base.
I guess using the sliding door is cool. Pro tip, always boil the water. Unless you want Daniel spraying nasty things on both ends. No way I can give any of these to Daniel. Too risky. Hello, motel room soap. Once you get used to squatting, it's not so bad. It feels weird to loot other people's clothes, but we need the warmth. At least we have fresh water in our front yard. No more peeing at night for Daniel. He got so scared. We're lucky he didn't blow up the house. This is rank. Sharing with Daniel was the worst. This room is fucking cold, so we put everything we didn't need in it and keep it closed. Thanks, Hank. Dickhead. Time to get warm. Yeah. Daniel doesn't need to see this. Wonder where Brody is now. Oh yeah, no internet. Feels almost good to be cut off from everything. Here we go.
Hold on, Mushroom. We're gonna build a fire. Starving.
Guess it's time to start cooking. He's definitely a fast learner. Maybe too fast. Guess it's time to start cooking. We scored with these clothes. Plus 5 street cred. Guess it's time to start cooking. Yum.
Too bad I can't make a pizza fly to us. I could start Daniel's delivery service.
Tough choice. Better talk to Daniel after dinner.
Hey, what are you cooking?
Oh, so tired of eating the same shit. I just want one slice of pizza.
Oh, I'm sorry. Here's your menu choices. Ravioli or ravioli?
Okay.
He looks so serious on this picture.
I still can't believe he's gone. I miss him so much, it hurts, Sean.
I know, Daniel. It's okay to think about him. I do it too.
Okay. Thanks, Sean.
These were all I found when I hit the town last week. Can't believe how much Daniel's powers have improved over the last weeks. So tired of eating the same shit. I just want one slice of pizza.
Hey, look! Our buddy Raccoon is back.
I got my eyes on him. He stole Mushroom's ravioli yesterday.
Yeah. Next time we'll call the forest cops. You whiskered thug.
How you doing, Mushroom? You're the best puppy in the world. I'm just glad we found you.
I wonder how far it can go. This room is fucking cold, so we put everything we didn't need in it and keep it closed. Daniel needs to eat something after all that psychic crap. Not ready yet. I'm a ravioli expert now. Mushroom clung to Daniel on the first nights, but now she loves her bed by the fire. Ready for today's training, puppy? Sit. Shroom, sit. Seriously, girl. Sit.
Mushroom. Sit, girl.
Are you kidding me?
You just don't know how to talk to her.
I'll remember this, traitor. Nah, it's not ready yet. I'm a ravioli expert now. There was a little bit left when we came. Pretty disgusting, but helps staying warm. Wish I had more than tobacco, to be honest. I wish I helped Dad more with the house chores back then.
Okay, dinner's ready.
getting sick of ravioli.
That was spaghetti alla dies. Didn't you taste the famous truffle sauce?
Yep. Plus, I love the garlic bread and ice cream. Yum. Ooh, you want some too, huh, Mushroom?
Bon appetit, Mushroom.
Man, she loves this stuff. Sorry, I'm cool.
Hold on. I need to show you something.
Okay.
Gotta show him the map. I think I left it with my books. Nothing here. Daniel, what did you do with the map?
What do you mean?
You know what I mean. Where's the map that was with my stuff?
I don't know. I'm not keeping track of your things.
We really lucked out stumbling into this house. Daniel's been sick for more than a week, and it keeps getting worse. Okay, come on, doggy. Let's go, girl. Hey, man, can you call your dog? I don't exist.
Mushroom, come here, girl.
What a great team. Time to play dad talk. I could do a super cool manga about Daniel. No way I'm touching that. Man, I miss listening to music so fucking much. Daniel loves his brand new tablet.
Sean, there's someone at the door.
What the? When did he show up?
I don't know. I just saw him now.
Daniel?
Got you!
Yeah, okay. Good job.
You almost shit your pants.
Of course I did, man. Anyway. Okay. I think it's time for us to hit the road. You're not getting better. We're almost out of supplies.
No, I'm okay. It's just a cough.
Yeah, a bad cough that won't go away. Trust me, Daniel. You need some medicine. Look. Here.
Beaver Creek? What's that?
That's where Karen's parents... our grandparents live.
Okay. So what?
So we can go there and... they'll probably help us.
Why do you always force us to run, Sean? What if they don't like me?
They're family, right? Plus they owe us for what Karen... for what Mom did.
You sure? It would be cool to spend Christmas with our grandparents.
Man, they're gonna love you. Grandpa's super cool, and I'm sure you guys will be best buds.
Well, okay. But Mushroom has to agree, too. She's part of the team. What do you say, girl? Okay, when?
Tomorrow. The sooner the better. We have a long road ahead.
We should do something fun for our last night here. How about a game of dice? If I win, I get the draw on your backpack.
You know I'm gonna win and draw a dick on your bag, right?
I don't think so, pussy. Party time. Okay, ready to lose, Captain?
Watch your butt, matey. Here we go. Just need a 6, a 5, and a 4. Oh! Got a ship now. Ahoy, Captain. I have a crew now. Here comes the loot. High score. Here you go, cargo. Better than nothing. Good luck beating that, matey.
Don't worry about that.
Your turn, lubber.
Nice. All right. I just need a 4 now. Yes. Ship, captain, and crew. I need the score now. Pretty please. Ooh, good throw. Pretty good.
Come on, my turn. Cool. Give me the same... complete ship. What the hell?
We'll see.
Okay, I've had enough. I give up.
What? For real?
Yep, you heard me. Yeah, okay. You want it. Here's my bag.
Let's see. Finished.
A poop? Really?
Yeah, it suits you.
Well, thank you very much. It's bedtime. Gotta get up early.
I'm gonna finish my comic book. She has to pee.
Okay, okay. I'll take her out for a walk.
You're going to smoke. It smells like ass.
You're right. Don't smoke. But it's our last night, so we can do anything. All right, all right. I heard you the first time, dude.
Thank you.
Hey, Daniel. How are you doing?
It sucks.
I'm coming.
Mushroom wants to go out. Don't you hear?
Yeah, sorry.
Move.
So, what's going on?
It doesn't fit in. There's too much stuff. It's fucking bullshit.
Hey, cool down. It's gonna be okay.
I know. But...
What did you pack in? What the f... Dude, you can't fit the whole room in. Don't worry. Your super strong big brother can help.
Awesome. Thanks, Sean.
Well, looks like we're almost set.
Where's Mushroom?
Still peeing, I guess?
I'm gonna check what she's up to.
Okay, I'll fill up our bottles and I'll catch up with you guys. Okay, all done. Where the hell is he? Daniel! Hey, you out here? Daniel! Where is he? We have a 2-day walk ahead of us. Better get going. Daniel? Where are you? What the fuck happened here? Dude, what are you doing? That's not good. Daniel? Oh, shit. Daniel! Do not move.
You killed her! She was my friend!
Calm down, okay? Listen.
Leave me alone! No!
I'm so sorry. Just
wouldn't have changed anything to kill it. I'm right here. It's all right. Here. You should do it.
That's it. It's bullshit. We can't even bury her.
Well, unless you want to say something.
Goodbye, Mushroom. You were such a good puppy. I'll always remember running through the snow with you. And how you snuggled. And I'll never forget you. Never.
Thank you, Mushroom, for looking after us in these woods. You won't be forgotten.
Sean, do you think she's up in heaven? With Dad?
Yeah. I'm sure he will look after her.
Wait. What about his allergies?
Don't worry, Inanna. There's no allergies up there. They'll be fine together. Okay. We should go. It's getting late.
Okay. Wish we didn't have to go. I like having a house again.
Come on. Let's hit the road.
What about my traps? Should we leave them up?
They'll protect the next runaways that stay here.
I put both you in charge of the house, Mushroom.
So long, my dudes.
We made it, Daniel. It's been a long time since I was here.
When was that?
Before you were born. Come here. Let me check you out. Claire likes everything super clean. Dad said she got pissed because he let me bring a snowball in the house. We don't want to look like total pigs.
What if they went on vacation? Or something?
We'll figure out something.
Yes, we hear you.
I'm sorry, we don't want any of...
Hello, Claire.
Sean? Oh my. Is that Daniel?
What's going on out here? I heard...
Look who's here! After all this time.
What the hell are you doing here?
Steven, watch your mouth.
Well... It's kind of a long story.
Oh, you poor thing. You know he's sick, right?
Yeah, but...
Okay, inside. Both of you.
Hey, is it warm enough for you?
Oh, yeah. Feels nice and toasty.
I gave Daniel some cough medicine, but you should have taken better care of him. He could have been worse. You were lucky. Steven, may I talk to you for a second?
Fuck. Did I make a mistake coming here? It's good to be inside. Finally. Oh, shit. I'm so hungry, my belly hurts.
Maybe we should call Gus.
I'm not sure.
I remember that. I think it used to be in the living room. I feel so awkward to be here.
The police officer was killed, Claire, you know? Our grandchildren are wanted by the police for murder.
I know. What if Sean is guilty? Sleeping in our home, next to us.
Let's just ask him what happened. Then we'll figure something out. Okay?
All right, Stephen. Oh, Lord. Are you all right, honey? You want more tea?
Thanks. I'm good.
Well, Sean, do you want to talk about...
The police called us a few weeks ago. They're looking for you as suspects in a homicide and for assault and robbery in a gas station? Now, if you want us to help you, did you hurt that police officer in Seattle?
Seriously? You really think I killed that cop?
No, don't get mad. Sean, we have to ask. We only know what we saw in the news.
All I know is that he shot dead. And now he's gone.
Oh, sweetie. We are so sorry for what happened to your father. But why did you run away if you're innocent?
I didn't want Daniel to see Dad. Like that. I felt like I had to protect him.
I understand, but...
You know the police would separate us. Maybe forever. Daniel would end up in foster care.
You can't be sure, Sean. Anyway, at least you've managed to come here alive. We're glad you two are okay.
I hate to think what could have happened to both of you. You need to think of long-term solutions now.
I tried. I swear. But I can't do everything.
So, what are your plans?
Go down to Mexico, to Puerto Lobos. Dad has a family house there.
Sean, you can't run away from the law like fugitives. How can you look out for your brother if you're both running from the police?
You two are gonna stay with us.
Oh, Stephen. Maybe we should...
After your mother left, your dad never really wanted us in your life. I can't blame him. But you're still part of our family, and we wanna prove it, okay?
Whoa, really? Aren't you scared? The police already called you.
Lordy, yes. But we're also scared for you.
That's why you'll have to be careful around here. Beaver Creek is small and nosy.
We can stay? Serious? Awesome! Ooh, Sean, guess what? There's a huge model train upstairs.
Hey! You're supposed to be resting, young man.
Yeah, yes he is. But he seems better already. Anyway, you and Daniel will stay here. At least until Daniel's better. We'll see what happens next. So, I bet you're hungry. Let me fix you something.
How do you feel, Superwolf?
Way better. It's nice and warm in here. And the food? Yum.
Yeah. Feels good.
Feeling better? You look cozy.
Yeah. I love that bed. Thanks, Grandma.
Good. Your temperature is down.
I'm way better now.
You still need to take it easy.
How about if we say a little prayer and give thanks?
It's like a bedtime story, right?
Well, this is a bit like this, yes. Except the story comes from up there.
The ceiling.
So are we ready to pray? Just follow my lead.
Sure. We need all the help we can get.
Can you ask the Blessed Dad? And Sean? And Mushroom? And you and Grandpa? And, everybody else?
Oh my, you are so sweet. Thank you, Lord, for bringing Sean and Daniel safe and sound into our house. Take care of Esteban and, Mushroom. Please, give us the strength to get over the hardships of the past and the trials yet to come. Amen.
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 Okay, it's bedtime. Try to get some rest. You still need it. And no roughhousing in here.
No worries. We're too tired. Good night. Oh, and thanks again.
Good night, Grandma. It feels so nice to have a bed again. And a bathroom.
I hear that. Plus, you don't smell anymore.
Whatever. Well, Claire seems pretty caring. And nice. I guess Steven is too. I hope we'll be fine here.
I think so. And the more important thing is you'll have time to get better.
Sean? Are we in Mom's old room?
Nah, I don't think this is the one. Not from what I remember. But it's been a while.
Could we check it out tomorrow? Maybe find some of her stuff?
Why would you want to do that?
I just don't know anything about her.
Daniel, I understand. But we need to focus on where we are now and where we're off to. Mom left us. She made her choice. We gotta make ours. And we can't keep going back. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I guess.
Hey, man. You've been doing so great with your... Well, you know, I was wondering, how do you do it?
I don't know. I concentrate and it just happens.
Wait, does it hurt?
Nah. It's kind of itchy though, and exhausting.
Sorry. Anyway, remember the rules, right? We really don't want Claire or Stephen to start asking questions.
I know. Don't show, don't talk.
Just keep that in mind and everything should be fine. Sleep tight, little cub. I could sleep all day long in this bed. But I'm way too hungry. Claire wanted to throw her clothes away, but we convinced her that with some sewing and cleaning, it would be enough. All right. I'm allowed to go out now. That's cool Claire dug this up for us. Dad's such a baller in his suit. Wonder if Brody noticed his hula girl was missing. This is pretty good so far. I love that Steven only has crime and train books. Man, I miss that dirty little dog so much more than I thought I would. I don't even know how Beaver Creek looks like. We're not allowed to get out. Daniel looks like a total thug in his new pajamas. Thanks, Claire, but I will never wear these things. Daniel is training his precision with ease. Fucking awesome.
Sean! Finally.
Sean, are you awake? Breakfast almost done, so come down when you're ready, okay?
Okay.
Choo-choo!
What's up?
Ah, look who's here. But you're too late for the 9:15 express.
It's okay. I'll take the next one.
It will leave after breakfast. Don't be late this time.
I won't. It's been locked ever since we got here. And I kind of don't give a fuck. Oh, man. How did we survive for weeks out there with no hot water? I used to hate brushing my teeth, just like Daniel. Now I can't get enough toothpaste. Saw some teeth in there a few nights ago. Wonder if it's Claire's or Steven's. Wow, they sure did stock us up on clothes for the winter. Hope I'll never have to hold on to a Bart to take a shit. They have so many pills and stuff to take. Sucks to be old. It's crazy how everything is neat and tidy here. Quite the change from our last home. Better hit the kitchen quick. Claire's waiting for us. Steven doesn't like us in here when he's away. It's weird. Sometimes I feel like we're complete strangers. Which we kind of are.
Oh my, look who's awake. Good morning, sleepy. Daniel, breakfast time. Your brother is ready.
Grandma, show me your Bart star.
Steven. Your grandson needs to eat now. You can show him the boxcar later. I love how they're getting along.
Do you need help or anything?
Oh, don't worry. I can do this in the dark. But thanks for the offer.
All right.
Are you boys done playing?
We had an express delivery with the passengers, but the engine broke down.
Yep, has to go straight to the workshop.
Good. No trains in the kitchen, remember?
Gotcha, Chief.
Choo-choo!
Oh, sugar. He can fix his trains, but not my kitchen. Did I make enough? Everything's okay?
It's great, as usual.
You're the best cook ever.
Looks like you're getting cozy with this new country life after all.
Yeah, it's nice to be far away from everything.
feels like we're the only ones out here.
Well, that's exactly why we love it. It feels safe, unlike the big city.
I get it.
I like it. It's cool here.
Well, bless your soul. You'd get along good with our neighbors. We try to lend a hand, like to Charles next door. He lost his wife, and things have been hard on him and his son. He would just get lost in Seattle. But we're all taking care of him here.
How old is his son?
I think he's your age.
Ooh, cool.
Hey, what's going on back there?
Nothing.
Oh, I thought Steven was a fast eater.
Hey, Grandma, I wanted to ask you something about that locked room upstairs.
I told you there is nothing to see in it, Daniel.
Why were you in it this morning then?
Because there's a lot of old junk in there. And besides, it's not safe for you to explore, okay?
This is bullshit.
Daniel, language. Why don't you go explore outside? You sure look like you're getting better. Get some fresh air.
I'll wait for Sean, and then we'll go. We won't be loud. Promise.
But be careful nobody sees you. Stay in the back, okay?
Maybe you should tell him that it was Karen's room.
And maybe you should tell him to watch his mouth. It's just a room now, Sean. Nothing to see.
Daniel needs that. He doesn't know anything about her.
I know, poor thing. But his mother isn't in there anymore. So nobody goes in the room, okay? I'm serious.
It's cool. I don't care. She left us anyway.
Yes, Sean. She left all of us. Anyway, you have to respect my rules under my roof, okay?
Of course. Always.
I appreciate that, Sean. Now you better go find your brother. There's a shed with some old toys outside. I'll bet Steven has the key.
Daniel, old freak. Thank you. Claire could totally be on one of those cooking shows. She would be brutal. Yeah. Pretty different from the one we had back at home. Clean kitchen equals clean conscience.
Hold on.
Hmm.
As always with Claire, I can't really tell if this is cute or bossy. I better catch up with Steven and get those keys. Daniel's going nuts in here.
I'm done.
I can't believe Steven spent his whole life building this. He's a real artist.
Think I need a handy assistant. Can you hand me the glue in the cupboard behind me?
Sure.
Whoa! Careful. Sorry, I forgot. That thing isn't too stable. Let me just...
Okay. Sorry.
My fault. Your grandmother keeps telling me, but I'm a lazy old man. Hey, can you close the door? I want to talk for a second.
Oh.
It's the power cable, of course. Yeah, it happens all the time. So, listen, I've noticed things with Daniel. You know what I'm talking about, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
But how the heck is that possible? I mean, he can... Well, you know more than me.
Not really. It started in Seattle after... everything happened. I wish I could explain, but that's how it is now. And we have to live with it.
I really don't know what to think. He needs a doctor. Or something.
Then I'd probably never see him again.
Yeah, I get it. He needs you. More than anything else. And by the way, let's keep this between us. Claire has a lot of strong beliefs. She wouldn't understand. She adores Daniel and just wants both of you to be safe and happy. What I'm trying to say is maybe you should stay here with us. I know you boys plan to run to Mexico, but...
We have a home in Puerto Lobos. Dad wanted to return there. Two Mexican boys out on the run. That won't be a secret in Beaver Creek for long.
America is your home. With us. And you have to think about your brother, you know, his future, all that stuff.
It's too dangerous for us to stay here. And for you guys too.
It's dangerous to be on the road. Do you think your father would have wanted this for his kids?
Of course not. But everything's different now.
I know. Well, just think about it. But don't torture yourself.
I will. Hey, Claire said you had the keys for the tool shed?
Oh, sure. Here. You guys enjoy the sun. And be careful with that shed. It's probably a mess inside.
Thanks.
It's good to see you in my lair. You know, you were afraid to come in here as a kid.
Really? Why?
No idea. But you're a big boy now. You can take a look around. I won't eat you.
Cool. It's okay. It's been a while since I've seen her face.
Yeah. I like taking a look at it from time to time.
Doesn't it hurt?
Yeah, it does. But she's still my daughter, you know. I can't approve what she's done, but I think I understand.
Good. I don't.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Jean. Please don't... please don't say anything to Claire about this, okay?
Don't worry. I won't.
So here is me already.
Steven sure takes his hobby.
Yeah, just gotta unscrew this. I'm sorry, Sean. I know you guys miss your games and your websites. But trust me, a break from all this can only do you good. You know, and it's safer that way.
Yeah. I know. How come you have a disco ball? Are you, like, throwing parties and stuff?
No, this is a souvenir, you know? I actually met your grandma during a disco night. Mm. Believe it or not.
For real? That's so cool.
She was such a good dancer. We danced the hustle. And I knew I was going to marry that woman.
Aww. By the way, I have no idea what you're talking about, but it sounds so very cute.
Well, I'd show what it is if only these hips allowed me to.
Man, who did this?
Oh, it was our neighbor's son, Chris. Yeah, I helped him and his dad build that treehouse.
Why are you holding a fire sword?
I'm not sure. You know, that kid sure has an imagination.
Wow. Is that you?
Yeah, that was taken when I retired. The mayor came to congratulate me himself.
That's awesome.
Yeah, really great day. I wish you'd been here.
Oh, there you are, Sean. Got the key? Hey, I have to go out and run some errands. Can you do me a big favor? Do you know how to work a washing machine?
Since I was about 8.
Of course. Can you throw in yours and your brother's clothes after the next load? They're in the bathroom basket.
Totally, yeah. No problem.
Thank you so much. Feel free to start tidying your stuff, too. It's good for the health to keep a house clean.
Definitely. Daniel can help.
And remember, for your own safety, no phone and no internet. I know, boring rules.
Don't worry, Claire. Hey, Daniel! There's work for you.
No. I'm busy.
Busy my ass! Come over here.
You gotta find me first.
Jeez. Oh. This used to be Karen's room. Wonder what they've done with it. Better not sneak in. They won't like it. I know you're in there. Gotcha! What the?
Behind you!
Yeah, very funny. No more hiding. Seriously.
Okay. What do I have to do?
You tidy the mess in our room, and I take care of the laundry. Cool?
Again? We always have to clean everything. I don't wanna.
Yeah, I hear you. Never mind, okay?
Cool. Thanks, Sean.
All right, let's get it over with. Fuck. I broke this thing like 10 years ago. I can't believe they fixed it and kept it. All right, time to take care of that laundry. How many programs does this thing have? Okay, it will do. It's cool that Claire does her little paintings. I wonder where this was taken. I don't picture Claire and Steven as world travelers. I haven't seen any actual fish in there since we got here. I'm glad I picked these up. Gives me something to work on when they're all watching TV. Tried one of Claire's books yesterday. It's basically a telenovela with white old women.
Hey, I want to be in your drawing. I'm not moving. Hope I look good.
Cool. I think I'm ready to draw this.
I'm not moving. Hope I look good.
Nope. I can't do anything without looking up first.
I'm not moving. Hope I look good.
Pretty
not
good.
Not moving. Hope I looked.
But I can add more details if I want.
I'm not moving. Hope I look good. I'm not moving. Hope I look good.
Such a big fireplace. And not even needed. That's luxury. Boring laundry? Done. Time for fresh air. Whoa. Look at all these decorations.
That's so cool.
Of course he begged for these. Can't really blame him, though. After a month on canned food. See you tonight, buddy. Claire can draw pretty damn good. Guess it runs in the family. I don't know when Daniel will be able to go back to his school. We stopped our... That's a cool memento of our secret cabbing in the woods. Come on, man. I put all your toys in the trash, dude.
What? Really?
Of course not. But next time you bail on me, maybe I will. It's so weird to be back here again. Claire and Steven are kind of weird sometimes, but they do care about us. I'm glad they're spoiling Daniel. Wish I could.
Careful! Sean!
Oh, shit!
Got you.
Seriously, man.
Pussy.
I heard Claire rehearse some songs. She's got the groove. Come on. We've been inside long enough. All right. Time to see the sun again. Okay. Time to burn off some calories. What do you say?
Ha-ha! Yes! So good to be outside. Reminds me of the cabin. Right? Ow! Ow!
Ow! Ow! Ow! Ow!
Watch out for the pack.
Get ready for storage wars.
What's wrong?
Frozen shut. Of course.
Sean, look!
See what? We just got here. Are you okay?
Yeah. I didn't see anything either.
Okay. I just fell down into the snow. Dad says I'm kind of clumsy.
That's an awesome costume. Who's your favorite superhero? I love
Power Bear. Oh, man! I have the Mega Power Bear. You should check it out.
Dude, that's so cool.
Chris, oh, God. Look, I am so sorry. Are you okay?
Dad, I'm fine. I promise.
Are you sure? Listen, I shouldn't... Do you know them?
It's okay, Dad. They're cool. He loves superheroes, even Power Bear.
Ah... Gotcha. Hey there. Are you staying with the Reynolds?
Oh, yeah. They're our grandparents.
I see. Oh, geez, Chris. You don't have any damn shoes on. I'm sorry, buddy. Let's get you inside.
Yeah. Okay, Dad.
Thanks, guys. Oh, and, if Claire asks, tell her everything is fine.
Sure. No problem.
Cool. See you around, then.
Thanks, guys. See you later.
Yes, we will.
Daniel! Did you forget everything about the rules already?
Sorry, Sean. Did you want me to let him fall? Really?
No, you... You did the right thing. But listen, we can't let anybody know. We have to keep a low profile out here.
He's like my age. I bet you would have done the same exact thing. Don't be mad.
I'm not mad, dude. It's...
It's over. Daniel, remember that we're hiding out. So no training and no showing off your power. From now on, you stick with me all the time, okay? Fuck. That kid never listens. Okay. Time to get Daniel at the Erickson's. Claire? Steven? Anybody home? Well, looks like I'm home alone. Oh, right. Sunday morning. Claire and Steven must be at church. Steven and Claire are gonna freak if they realize he went to the Erickson's. Well, I guess they won't be back for at least 2 hours. Maybe I could use Steven's laptop. It's been ages since I've had news from the real world. Okay, let's get this brack back home now. Why does Daniel never listen? Maybe I'm too soft with him. That's a lot of beer. Daniel, what's going on here?
Sean, wait, don't freak out. I can't explain.
Let me tell him. Sean, I know it sounds crazy, but I have a superpower. You saw me yesterday. I know you did. I was flying. I can move things. Objects with my mind.
Oh, a superpower. Really?
Yes.
Well,
That's pretty cool, Chris. So, you're like a superhero?
I'm Captain Spirit. I can bend any matter to my will. But that's my secret identity, so you can't tell anybody.
Oh, I can keep a secret, Captain Spirit.
Now you're an official member of the Spirit Squad. If you betray us, I'll disintegrate you. Nah, just kidding. Oh yeah, we need a... team signal.
Totally! I'm gonna be Super Wolf. What's your super name, Sean?
I don't know. Something cool like El Diablo Loco.
Sounds like a supervillain's name, but okay.
Okay, guys, I think we're ready to roll. Excuse me. Who are you?
I'm Sean.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, man. You're here for Daniel. Hey, let's make it official. I'm Charles Erickson.
Nice to meet you.
Hope you know that Daniel and Chris are a dangerous team. We better watch out, or they're gonna take over the world.
Yeah. They share a lot of things. As thick as thieves.
Can we go get the Christmas tree now? We're both ready to fly.
Yes, yes, yes. The team has been waiting too long. Hey, you should come along too. There's nothing going on over here.
Yes! Can't wait to see all the decorations. And Sean, we could buy Christmas presents for Grandma and Grandpa.
Well, they'll worry if we leave the house. And remember, you still have to get better, Daniel.
Sean, come on. You know I haven't done anything fun since I got sick. It's the first time I've been out for days.
We won't be gone for long. The market's only a few miles away. Anyway, they'll be at the service for at least another hour.
Yeah, Sean, I can show Daniel around. You can come with us. Please say yes.
Please, please, please.
Okay, you win. Not a fair fight. So let's go.
Yes!
Yeah!
See? Dangerous. Okay, team, give me a time out to clean up the back seat. I'll honk when I'm done.
Ooh, can I use the bathroom?
Of course. Oh, you'll see my comic books. I'm glad you're coming, too. Hey, you want to see my toys?
Oh, score! The new hot dog man?
Since you're a new member of the team, you have to know everybody. These are Captain Spirit's friends and his enemies.
Dude, that's pretty cool.
Can you guess who are the good guys and the villains?
Let's see.
Careful. It may be tricky. You sure? Interesting.
Okay. How did I do?
You're good. You guessed all right. You deserve a little reward. It's an interstellar traveler. I gave the other one to Daniel.
Wow. Thanks, Chris. That's all.
After all, you're part of the team now. Okay, let me introduce them to you. This is Team Spirit, the good guys. There's the Forest Warrior, Power Bear, Marty Rex, and Sky Pirate.
So, who are the bad guys?
That's Noctarius and the Shark Stinger. There's also Snowmancer, but he's out in the garden. Captain Spirit kinda took care of him. He might need a little surgery now. But they're all working for Mantroid, who is the real supervillain. You should see his evil planet.
Why doesn't Captain Spirit stop him?
He tried, but failed. That's why he needs Super Wolf. You know, Daniel, to prevent Mantroid from hurting other people.
Yeah, strength in numbers. Sounds like Mantroid is in trouble.
Just wait until he sees what Captain Spirit can do now.
Yeah, about that. Does your dad know about any of this? Did he see something yesterday?
No, he didn't see anything, and the power didn't work yesterday. After I fell, must have been too tired.
Okay, good. He could be pretty disturbed if he knew.
I'm definitely not telling Dad. I don't want to freak him out. He's worried about other stuff anyway.
Well, your dad is cool. He totally hooked you up with that treehouse.
Yeah, he let Steven build it for me. It's my flying fortress.
Oh, yeah. I saw that drawing you made of him. With that badass blazing sword.
I made it to thank him for making the treehouse. Well, Captain Spirit had to help him, of course.
Obviously. All hail Captain Spirit, the first and only Carpenter Vigilante. There's the signal. Come on, Daniel.
Hey! Pro tip, don't go in there.
Yeah.
Okay, squad, let's roll. You need my jacket? I don't want you catching another cold.
No, I'm good. Thanks.
And don't be waving your arms around when I'm driving, okay?
Yeah. Remember, Daniel, don't mess around.
All right. Jeez.
Thanks for clearing the snow from the porch. You're awesome.
You're welcome, Dad.
Okay, buddy, you ready?
Yeah. Hey!
You guys go ahead and we'll come back to meet you, okay? Brothers meeting.
Sure.
But
don't get lost.
Dude, what the fuck are you doing? I can't believe it. How many times do we have to keep going over the rules?
Don't show the power. I know. But Tris thinks he can do all this cool stuff. I wish he could. He reminds me of Noah. I just miss having friends, Sean.
Listen, I understand, but we have to be extra careful out here. You can't let people see you. You know the rules.
Yes, I know the rules.
But I'm careful. I only do things when it's me and Chris. Nobody sees us.
Yeah, nobody but me. What if it was Chris's dad? Or grandma? Or a cop? Or...
Okay. I get it. But I'm careful.
That's not enough. You have to be extra, extra careful.
All right. I swear I will.
Deal. I'm counting on you and Anna.
Can I go see Chris now?
Yeah, let's go. But don't forget what I said.
Wow! So many trees! Are you coming, Sean?
Don't worry.
I know.
I'll be around. Jeez. Daniel Snowman wasn't that creepy after all.
Nothing. I'll tell you later. So, what do?
We have to pick the one we like. Can Daniel help, Dad?
Of course he can.
Awesome. Come on, no time to lose.
Okay, just pick the one you like and come get me. Deal?
Deal.
I've never been on such a dangerous mission.
Yeah, these wild trees are just waiting to eat us.
We'll have to tame the one we want.
Hey.
Hey, Sean. What's up?
Just wanted to thank you for bringing us out here.
Hey, no problem. I hope you'll find what you're looking for. It's kind of a tiny place.
It's perfect. Don't worry. Good luck with that tree.
Yeah, I sure need it. It's not an easy task with this guy. Come get me when you're done.
I will. Behold, the giant condom machine. Okay, better find a gift for Daniel quick, while he's still busy with Chris. Dad pushed every year to get a plastic tree, but we never surrendered.
Not that many blue spruces left.
Dear Santa, we've been good kids this year. Please explain this hot mess.
Good. Tell me if you need anything.
Is that a yo-yo? Daniel had one back home. Bet he'd love this. This is so different from Seattle. Don't know if I can get used to it. Hi, everybody. We're taking a year off to run away from cops. Daniel has got telekinesis now. Hope you're doing well.
We only sell handmade local products. Come take a look. You won't find better deals in Beaver Creek.
I'd like one of those snowman things.
Of course. They're handmade by local kids.
Cool. Here you go.
Thanks. Anything else?
No. I'm good.
Have a nice day, then.
Yeah, you too. Thanks. Cool. Mission accomplished. We better leave now, before Claire and Steven come back. Okay, got it. I've looked enough. Time to draw now. This place is nice. Pretty good. But I can add more details if I want. Cool. I think I'm ready to draw this. Time to take the pen, dude.
What are you drawing? Whoa, it's so cool. Are you like a professional?
Nah, more like the opposite.
You could draw comic books, the awesome adventures of Captain Spirit and Super Wolf.
Pretty rad for a Hollywood name. Yeah, I'll think about it.
Hey, can you add something funny to your drawing?
Funny? Like what?
I don't know. Something cool.
Okay. Big question. Zombies or UFO? I've looked enough. Time to draw now.
I hope I can draw like you one day.
I'm sure you will, man. Seems like Charles is waiting for...
Found what you were looking for, city boy?
Yeah. Something for my little brother.
You bought your brother something out here. Damn. Poor kid. Sorry. I'm just a grumpy old gal. Me and my friends have been crashing here for the week. Nobody... gives a shit about us. Yeah, I can tell you're not from around here.
No way. Just here for the holidays.
Ah. You got family?
My grandparents.
Gotta love the grandparents.
What about you and your friends? Road trip?
Not really. We kind of hop from place to place, hunting for little jobs.
Must be a long ride.
That's okay. We hop on trains. Gives us time to rest.
Man, that sounds wicked.
You have no idea. It's free and so fucking fun. Well, unless you get caught or fall, but we've been lucky so far.
That's the best.
Nobody tells us what to do. No corporation owns us.
And you get to see so many cool places.
Exactly. Next stop is Humboldt County, California.
Stoner break.
Not even close. We actually got work over there.
Sean, what are you doing? We've hit the tree with Chris. It's all crooked like an old witch. Oh, hi. Who are you? Ooh, your hair looks so cool. Is it a wig?
Well, what do you think?
I don't know, but it's really cool. I'm Daniel. What's your name?
Hi, Daniel. I'm Cassidy. I dig your superhero outfit.
I'm on a secret mission with my friend. It's very dangerous.
I can tell. I hope you get your mission accomplished. And what's your name?
Sean. I thought I told you.
No, you did.
Sorry, you went through some shit with the guys. How much you make? You ready? Hello, pups.
Ooh, is that your doggy? So cool.
Yeah, he's been through a lot. Like most of us. So we adopted him. And he stinks. Yeah, you stink and you like it, huh?
Well, he's not the only one.
Have you checked your hair? I think it just twitched. You should keep your distance, dude.
Hey, never too careful. Who knows what may crawl out of there?
Oh, the pros joined forces. You're already perverting him, Finn.
Sorry. I know suburban boys is your thing.
Are you kidding? You want to talk about your scoreboard, hotshot?
Hey, no worries.
Come on, let's bail.
It was nice meeting you, Sean and Daniel.
Stay out of trouble,
goodbye.
Kids.
Goodbye.
Hope we see you on the rails someday.
Yeah. See you around.
That doggy was so cute. I miss Mushroom.
I miss her too.
Hey, excuse me. Dogs have to be on a leash around here. Too many strays.
Sorry, dude. We don't do leashes.
Well, the city does. An unleashed dog is liable to a fine, so...
You're gonna fine our dog? Well, that's not very nice.
Loitering is illegal, too. And you don't live here, right? Right?
Calm down, sweetie. We're allowed to visit the Christmas market. Our dog's not gonna eat you. Look at him.
You better watch your mouth. You punks are always causing trouble. This is a nice town, okay?
Jeez. Someone needs to get laid.
He's out of pills.
That's it. I'm calling the cops.
Oh, God. He's gonna call the cops on us, Finn.
Chill out. We're leaving this shithole anyway. You guys don't even have a Santa, for Christ's sake.
Merry Christmas!
Fucking parasites.
Why did they fight? I don't get why he yelled like that. We should kick his ass, Sean.
Better not get involved, man. This guy doesn't look nice.
You're right. They're pretty.
Whoa. The guy who painted that, he must have been seriously high.
So cool. How do I look, Sean?
Ridiculous.
You're jealous because I'm cute. You're a loss.
Hey, you guys ready to go?
Yeah. All done.
Cool. Hop in. Are you having too much fun back there?
Yeah.
That's what I thought. Looks like Daniel found a new brother.
No kidding. He dumped me like a rock.
I'm glad you two came along. It's great that Chris found a new friend out here. It looks like you did too. What's her name?
Cassidy? Cassidy.
Cute name. Do you like her?
She was cool.
You're too quick! Ah!
Anyway,
got ya!
It's good for me to get out, too. We've had a rough time over the past couple of years. My wife, Emily, she died 2 years ago. Obviously, it was tough on Chris.
Shit. I'm sorry, man.
Thanks. It's been a struggle, especially trying to be a good dad.
You're doing your best. Chris is awesome. And he's got a wonderful imagination.
Well, thanks for saying that. Chris does have talent. He's a storyteller.
Yeah. He showed up when I was drawing at the market. He gave me some tips.
When I look at you and Daniel, how close you two are, I realize I'm far from being up to the task. Chris deserves a real family. Anyway, I shouldn't have brought this up. Okay? Forget it.
No worries. Didn't mean to make you feel bad.
We all have our ups and downs, right? That's how life works. Your grandparents sure did have their share of downs, too. But they're always there for us. For Chris. They seem like good people.
Yeah, my mom left my dad a long time ago. She never came back. She broke all ties with her parents, too.
Sorry for bringing that up.
It's okay. I hope they don't stress out because we haven't come back.
Yeah, we should get you two home. Don't keep them waiting.
Yeah.
Hey, buddy. Wanna set up that Christmas tree?
Yeah!
Well, I'll get there before you with my dadmobile.
No way you can beat Captain Spirit. See you later, Super Wolf.
Hello? Hello? Claire? Steven?
Looks like Grandma and Grandpa haven't come back from church yet.
Well, at least they won't yell at us for going out.
That was so cool to spend time with Chris at the market. Did you know Chris's mom was an artist?
I didn't. How so?
She drew comics. You should see her drawings. They're so cool. Just like yours.
Thanks, dude.
Hey.
What? What is it?
Sean? I want to go check on the room. Upstairs. I know it's Mom's. Please.
Daniel, you heard Claire. They will freak out if they know we went inside.
We won't tell them. We'll be in total stealth mode. They won't know anything if we make it quick. It's just, I really want to know what's inside. What kind of stuff she had. Chris has tons of things that belong to his mom. And I have nothing. Come on, Sean. You don't even have to come with me. If you don't want to.
Fuck it. I'll come with you. So you don't make a mess that can get us caught. We'll find a way to open it.
Or I could just blow this stupid door up with my power. That looks super easy.
Yeah, I could do that with a hammer. But let's try and find the key instead, all right?
I'm just gonna clean up real quick.
Locked drawer. Maybe the key to Karen's room is inside.
Dude.
Who knew this sweet little muffin would turn into such a brat? Still super cute, though.
I'll stay here in case they come back.
Yeah, no. No way I'm searching Claire's underwear. Sharp objects. Bit like Claire. Come on, little key. Don't be shy. Definitely not the one. Way too small. Wonder what would have been different if Dad had taken us to church. How much more Irish can you be? Yes, Daniel, I know. I can't. Okay, Stephen. Where do you hide this key? We clearly don't share politics, but at least Stephen doesn't preach. I don't really see Steven listening to old school pop rock music. Yeah, not much to see in here. Clothes, old stuff, but definitely no hidden key.
Sean!
Shit, these are Christmas presents? Let's not tell Daniel. Or he'd freak. Daniel, you really think you could open this door without doing too much damage?
Yes, I know I can't.
Gotta find a way to open that door, or Daniel's gonna keep ranting about it. I gotta find a way to open that door, or Daniel's gonna keep. Okay, Daniel. Think hard. What was she wearing? Yep, it's empty. Come on, where is this cardigan? This whole house is pretty much a huge washing machine. Come on, where is this cardigan? No way she wore it to church. Yes, found one key, so it better fit.
Just try it. Wow. There's not that much left.
Where do you think they put the rest of her stuff?
Claire and Steven must have thrown a lot of it away. The rest is probably packed in these boxes. It's like she almost never used those.
Sean? What do you think happened to all the stuff in my room? When we left?
I don't know, Enano. I wish I could answer that.
Okay.
I think I remember that one. Karen showed it to me once. Ulysses. Okay, Daniel, check this out. His name is Ulysses.
Like, the hero?
I guess.
So cool.
They looked happy. How could you send all of this to hell? These pictures are so random. Yeah, you finally left forever. Coward. Is that an amethyst? She was into New Age bullshit.
Hi, Ulysses.
Man, that pen pal sure loved listening to her own voice. Well, figures Karen was already looking for an exit. Guess the no phone rule wasn't such a thing back then.
So, you were a friend of my mommy's? I hope she took good care of you.
I don't recognize any of these games. Hope you enjoyed your trips. So you didn't bail on us for nothing. Read a lot of these in the 10th grade. Yawn. This playlist is boring as hell. I miss my music.
You're not that fluffy anymore, little bear.
Karen liked to take pictures of strangers when we walked down the streets. Never been a big fan of hiking. But here I was, walking my way down to Mexico. I think I saw a moon eclipse once, before Daniel was born. Karen was still with us then. I miss my skateboard and going to the park with Lila. They want to forget anything related to Karen. I can relate. I think it's not plugged. is wrong with this? Oh, hiding spot. Smart. So, Karen was already serious about running away. Why did you wait that long? This playlist is hell. Why would Claire lock these up in here?
Is that for Mom? Huh? Let me see.
Daniel! Come on.
What's it say? Read it.
Seriously, stop. Here, how about this?
I've heard the news about Seattle. Please help my boys if they come to you. What? Why did they hide this from us?
I don't know.
You can reach me at this address. It's a P.O. box I use sometimes. What's a P.O. box?
Well, a cop-out. In this case,
I beg you, please help my sons.
Oh, yeah, right. Total bullshit.
What do you mean? She cares about us.
Well, I don't.
Maybe she changed her mind. We could try and contact her.
You don't even know her, okay? Don't get any wrong ideas. We should just stick to our plan. For now.
Can I read it again?
Yeah. Then we gotta go.
My goodness.
Oh. Shit.
Excuse me. What are you both doing in here? Except visibly. Ransacking our house while we're at church?
Daniel just wanted to see the room.
Yeah, I did.
Sean. Don't shift the blame to your brother. You're supposed to be the adult.
Claire, please, calm down.
No, Stephen. They went way out of line here. We specifically told you to stay out of this room.
I have the right to see my mom's room.
This isn't her room anymore. There is nothing to see in here. It's time you learn to respect some rules.
What's that supposed to mean?
Maybe Esteban lets you boys do whatever you want, but that's not how things work here. We have rules and we have limits.
You didn't know, Dad. He raised us all on his own because of your daughter.
Sean, I didn't mean it like that.
I can't hear that.
Listen, Sean, I know life has been tough on you the past month. Bless your souls.
And we put up with a lot of things. But that, going through our stuff, our personal belongings, well, that shows you don't respect us. We could go to jail just for helping you. This is how you pay us back? Well, things are just going to change around here if you want to stay.
Man, I think I see why Mom left now. She couldn't put up with your stupid rules anymore.
Oh, so that's what you think. Then let me tell you something.
Huh?
Steven!
Oh, shit! Get this goddamn thing off me!
Steven, no! Hold on, honey, we'll get it off!
No! Stop! Oh, my legs! Do it, Daniel! Now!
Do what? What's going on? Oh, Lord, what? What are you doing, Daniel? Oh, my baby, Stephen, are you okay?
Now I am. Thanks to Daniel. You were right, Claire. I should have fixed that cupboard months ago. I guess my laziness will get me someday.
What in the name of God was that all about? That's impossible. What are you, Daniel?
Claire. Listen.
They saved me, Claire. That's all that matters.
Maybe. It was a miracle. Oh, thank you, Lord. It's the sheriff.
Stephen? Claire?
Sean, I didn't.
It's about your grandson.
We didn't call them.
I know, Grandma.
Someone called us. We know they've been here. They were spotted at the Christmas market earlier today.
Sean, what are we gonna do?
Go hide in the garage.
No. No. No way. If the police searches the house, that makes the two of you accomplices.
Get your bags and go out the back door. I'll distract him.
Really?
Yes. No. Get the hell out of here.
I know you're in here. Your car's in the driveway.
I'm so sorry for everything. I wish we could have helped you more. I wish you could stay here with us. Watch out for your brother, Sean.
Yes. Be careful. We'll see you as soon as we can, okay?
Thanks for helping us. Both of you.
Oh, we love you. Now hurry up.
Daniel, wait for me.
Thank you.
Why did Chris jump in front of that car, Sean? Why?
He's okay, Inanno. The car barely touched him.
You said I should be more careful. But because of you, I didn't do anything, and I could have.
Hey, you don't know what could have happened, okay? What's done is done.
You didn't even let me check on him. What if he is dead?
You could see the car slow down before, so Chris will be fine. Trust me.
You promise?
Promise.
Sean. I'm tired of running away. Why does my power always bring trouble?
You don't have to use your power if you don't want to.
But I'm good with it. And I'm the only one who can do these things.
I know, but Daniel, you need to be careful and listen to your brother.
You think we'll see Grandma and Grandpa again?
I don't know. We'll see.
Where are we gonna go now? See Mom?
No way, man. We don't need her, okay?
But she said she wanted to find us.
We stick to the plan. We go to Puerto Lobos. That's where we belong. No one will tell us what to do. We can be whoever we want.
You think? I don't know.
Trust me, man. From now on, we make our own rules. Look, I wanted to wait until then, but we kind of need a little cheer, so Merry Christmas, Inanno.
For me? Thanks, Sean. Hey, listen.
There's a ride. Come on, all aboard.
So, this is it?
Yeah.
It looks like a nettle field. And it stinks.
Yeah. And your stinky feet will cover the smell.
Shut up. They don't.
Come on. I'll show you around.